Welcome to this video, SAP Simple and Short. In this video, I would like to show and explain to you how you can set up your default parameters for your specific SAP user within SAP ERP and SAP S/4HANA. Enjoy this video and let's get started. Once you are logged in to the SAP system, you can reach your default parameters with two different ways. So the first one is you enter a specific transaction code in the command field, and that is SU3. Once you hit enter, then you end up in maintaining your user profile, and there in the defaults tab, you can maintain your defaults parameters. The other possibility is to use system, and then user profile, and then user data, and you will reach exactly also in here. Once you are in here, first of all, you can set up your start menu. So if we're going one step back, then right now we're seeing that because I haven't maintained any start menu, the default area menu is being shown, the S000, the standard menu. And if we're going once again to user profile, user data, or SU3, and then under defaults, and for example, if we would maintain a start menu, so for example, WEDI, hit enter, and then click on save or using the key combination control S, then we're right now seeing that this area menu is now my start menu. If you would like to change it back again to SU3 on default, I can totally erase it. And then if we're calling this once again, we're seeing that again the start menu is being shown. So this is quite useful to change your start menu. The second option is your logon language. If you would like to get to know more about the logon language, how you can change it easily, I would like to link to refer to a specific video I have already produced, because in there you specify your logon language. And this logon language is being used if you don't type in any logon language in the SAP logon before you're logging into the SAP system. And decimal notation, there you can decide between three notations how your numbers should be displayed in the SAP system. And keep in mind that this is user specific and this doesn't influence the way how the data is being saved in a database table. So this is just for your purpose, how the data should be shown in input fields and output fields, wherever. The next is the date format. Within here, you can decide between several options how the date should be formatted and shown to you. The next one is the time format. So what you prefer, how the time should be shown to your specific needs. And once again, those options don't influence the data in the database table, how the data is saved, only the output to you. Then down here, you have more specific settings to make. Down here, you can make some settings for the spool control. So here you can type in the output device. You can use the for help to get to know more information about the output control. So for example, there just with asterisks, you can search for different outputs and what you prefer. If you would like to get to know more about the output device, just set the focus into this field, then hit the F1 key on your keyboard, and then here you will get a nice description about the output device, about the setting in this field. Then here you can decide if you would like to print immediately your document or not. Once again, set the focus, hit F1, there you will get nice detailed description about this one. And here you can decide if the document should be deleted after output. So if you would like to get to more information about this, just set the focus, hit F1 key on your keyboard. Down here in the personal time zone area, there you can enter your specific time zone. And if this time zone is not entered, then the setting in the transaction STZAC is being used. And if there's also no time zone, then the system zone will be used. And down here for CATT, for computer aided test tool, there you can decide whether a test status should be set to your SAP user. And if you hit F1 key once again, then you will get nice detailed description about this flag. And if you made some changes, we've seen this already, and you would like to save this, then you can click on this save button or hit the key combination control S to save your settings. And then your settings are saved. Right now I haven't made any changes to my SAP user, and then the changes are ready to go. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you have learned about the default parameters in SAP ERP and SAP S/4HANA, and now you can change that if you want to. If you have any questions, then put it in the comment section. And now, please do not miss to subscribe to this YouTube channel. There will be great YouTube videos in the future. You will learn a lot and interesting facts about SAP ERP and SAP S/4HANA. Thank you very much for watching, and then see you in the next video.